blog channel, NWO report, Pentagon sharing says that sharing Christian faith could lead to court martial. Okay, and the Pentagon has released a statement confirming that soldiers could be prosecuted for promoting their faith, religious proselytization, I believe is how you pronounce it, excuse me, is not permitted within the Department of Defense. Now, court martials and non-judicial punishments are decided on a case-by-case basis. They released that statement to Fox News here recently, very recently. So what does that mean, guys? What does that mean for everyday Christians outside of the military? Well, they're starting this stuff in the military. They're trying to come up with ways to prosecute these guys in the military. For example, if someone in the military goes to his buddy and says, hey, man, you know, I found Jesus Christ a couple of weeks ago. You know, I just want to tell you right now that since I've been living for Christ, I've had a peace in me that I can't explain, and I want to share that with you. If that guy decides to go back and tell his commander what his friend said to him, he could get in trouble and court-martialed. And court-martial can lead to a lot of things by itself in other prison time, even death at some point. And I'm not saying that that's what they're going to do now, but we do know, according to the Bible, that eventually all this stuff is going to lead to Christians losing their lives, as some has already now in our time, to their faith. What does that mean for everyday Christians like me and you, or the ones who are listening and watching this video out there? It means that we are living in the last days, like I've repeatedly said here, and others have said here on YouTube. It's time to stop playing games out there. If you guys are going to live for Christ, live for Christ. That goes for me as well. Okay? I don't post stories like this up here to scare people into trying to live for Christ. I'm posting these stories simply because these are the times that we stay in. And these things that I report about up here, stories like this one on screen now and other stories on this channel, these things are going to get worse, guys. They're going to get worse than what they are. So we have to stand strong. If you haven't repented out there, I know I've been saying that a lot here, and I'm going to keep saying it. If you haven't repented out there, guys, we are running out of time. Time is short. All these signs are coming up just left and right. And as we get farther into 2013, things are going to get worse than they are now. That is a guaranteed fact. I assure you of that. They're going to get worse than they are now. So if you haven't already, get on your knees, repent, ask Jesus Christ to forgive you for your sins. Thank him for getting on that cross, dying for your sins. And you will be saved once you believe that with all your heart. Repent, turn from your sins, walk with Jesus, develop a relationship with him, obey him, and be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Okay? He will cover you and your family. You will be protected from all this craziness that's coming in this world. Some of us Christians may actually lose our lives in the coming days for our faith. But what does God say about that? Well, in 2 Timothy 2:1-2:3, I believe it was, Paul was talking to his son in 2 Timothy. And what does he say? What does Paul say to his son in that verse? He says, thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus, in the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses. The same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. In other words, be strong in your faith, teach other people of Jesus Christ and of his teachings. And also he says in verse 3, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. In other words, what he's saying there is, be strong like a soldier. Stand strong like a soldier in your faith for Jesus Christ and teach others. Tell other people about Jesus Christ and the good news and what can happen once you turn your life over to him, how you can be protected. Don't be ashamed. Be strong like a soldier, like it says in 2 Timothy. And stand strong to that faith. And God will bless you abundantly. I assure you of it. And again, like I've said before here, you'll have a peace in you that I can't even describe in words. Okay? Guys, support this channel by going to our news blog, NWO Report, linked under this video. Support this channel by following us on NWO Report. Follow us on Twitter, NWO Report at Twitter. follow us on this channel. Subscribe to us, guys. Support this channel. Again, this story can be found at our news blog. Our news blog is updated 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And again, this story says that was released by the Pentagon not too long ago. Sharing Christian faith could lead to court-martial for military people in the military. Okay, that also eventually is going to be talking about regular old, good old God-fearing Christians out here that's not in the military. You know, once that stuff starts in there, it's going to filter out to us here. Things are going to get hard, guys. Go read this story over at the NWO Report, our news blog, linked under this video. And again, guys, time is short. I beg of you guys out there. And I, if I didn't love you, I know I don't know you, but I love you guys out there. We're all brothers and sisters in Christ. Don't be ashamed to proclaim God's word. I'm not. I get criticized and cussed out all the time on this channel. But be strong. Keep the faith. Do not be ashamed of Jesus, and he won't be ashamed of you. Proclaim the gospel. Stand strong. And if you haven't, repent, turn to the Lord, walk with the Lord, obey him, and be baptized with the Holy Spirit.